हेलो व्यूअर्स, होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग एब्सोल्युटली फाइन। सो वी आर एट अवर थर्ड पार्ट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर, दैट इज द सेल यूनिट ऑफ लाइफ। एंड इन टूडेज वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस टू इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट्स, दैट इज सेल शेप वेरीज अकॉर्डिंग टू द फंक्शनल रिक्वायरमेंट्स, एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट विच आई विल डिस्कस हेयर इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ सेल्स। सो हेयर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल cells. So let's start with cell shape according to the requirement. So the first part which I will discuss here is that the cell shape varies according to their functional requirement. Now in case of multicellular organisms, we know that we are having specific cells for specific function, and the cells of specific type which are having specific functions, they are also varies in their shape, size and structures. Now here are some of the examples of cells and why they are having different shapes. We will also learn the reason behind them. So it is in case of red blood cell, we can see here that the biconcave shape. So red blood cells are having biconcave shape so that it can easily pass through blood capillaries for oxygen transportation. So to pass through the blood capillaries, and the response is very immediate, that's why it has a biconcave shape, so that it can easily transport oxygen to the body. Now next we can see that white blood cells are amoeba like so basically white blood cells are having major role for defensive mechanism and their activity is totally like amoeba. So what they basically do, they change their shape around the foreign particle. Suppose this is foreign particle and this is macrophage cell. So these macrophage cells of WBCs, what they do, so basically white blood cells are having nucleus in them, whereas red blood cells are not having nucleus. So what this macrophage cell will do, it will engulf this food particle by changing its shape, and later it will become like this. So foreign particle will get into the WBC, and this particular mechanism is known as phagocytosis. So basically this is the process where foreign particles got engulfed by WBC. So this is how the defensive role is played by white blood cells, and the whole process of phagocytosis is similar to the amoeba. That's why it is also known as amoeboid movement, because amoeba movement is with the pseudopodia, that is false feet. Now next we will see the example of nerve cells. So nerve cells are known as the longest cells, and the length is around 1 meter. So why they are the longest cells? Because they help in conducting impulse from distant body part to the brain and from brain to the distant body part. So it has to travel long distance for conducting impulse. So that's why they are the longest known cells in our body. Next, guard cells. Guard cells are mainly the stomata cells, which are present in plant, and they are like beam shape, like kidney bean. They are kidney bean, or they have a kidney like structure. So basically what they do, they are mainly playing role for the exchange of gases by closing and opening of this bean like structure, which is known as guard cells. So basically guard cells are responsible for gaseous exchange in leaves. So what we can see here, that different cells are having different functionalities, and according to the functions what they are performing, they have their own structure or shape. Now this is the structure of an animal cell which is observed under electron microscope, and now I am going to label this structure. So the outer layer of an animal cell is known as cell membrane. The outer layer is known as cell membrane. Now, the space here which we can see is known as cytoplasm. So this cytoplasm is completely a semi-fluid area which is filled with semi-fluid material. Mainly the constituents are water, salts, ions. Now next what we can see here, that this structure in an animal cell is known as Golgi apparatus. And these are the vesicles of Golgi apparatus. Now next, this structure we can see is known as centriole. This is lysosome. This is known as peroxisome. Now this structure is known as endoplasmic reticulum, and these endoplasmic reticulum are in two forms. One form is known as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. And so basically these are flattened tube-like structures, and they are of two forms. And the structure of other form is also similar, but one thing which differentiate between them is the presence of ribosomes on the surface of one endoplasmic reticulum. So these are the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Now these rough endoplasmic reticulum are having ribosomes attached to their surface.
and they are the sites mainly responsible for protein synthesis. Now these structure we can see that they are having no ribosomes attached, so we call them smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So these are the two form of endoplasmic reticulum. Now next, what we can see is a membrane like structure, and this membrane is known as nuclear membrane. And on this membrane there are certain spores present on the membrane which are helping in transportation of protein synthesis material, mainly rRNA, that are found in nucleolus. So nucleolus is the again the site where protein synthesis takes place, and here the type of RNA formed are ribosomal rRNA. So these type of RNAs are formed in nucleolus. Now next we can see this thread-like structure. So this thread-like structure is known as chromatin network. These are known as chromatin network, and these chromatin network are present with the DNA, and the DNA segments are having genes which are responsible for the character inheritance. Now next structure we can see here, this is known as mitochondria, and this is again a very important membrane bond organelle of animal cell, and it is also known as power of house of the cell. So these are certain organelles which are present in animal cells, and each organelles are having their own functions. And now we will see the particular structure, the functions of these organelles of animal cells.
So now I will start with part-wise explanation of animal cells. And the outer layer is the cell membrane. And this cell membrane is composed of lipid bilayer. And the lipid bilayer is mainly formed of lipids and proteins. So lipids are mainly phospholipids. And what the cell membrane do in animal cell, they are very much responsible for selective permeability. That means they will allow the substances like fluid substances, gaseous substances, only which are essential for the cell. Now next part is cytoplasm. So cytoplasm is the fluid material which is having mainly water, iron, salts, and this cytoplasm is major site for the production of pyruvic acid by the process of glycolysis. So many other things like amino acids and carbohydrates are also present in this particular cytoplasm. And what are its functions? And within cytoplasm, the inclusion bodies are present and organelles are present. Now cell membrane is the outer layer. Within the cell membrane, the whole cell membrane is filled with cytoplasm, and they are having organelles and inclusion bodies. So basically, inclusion bodies are mainly food vacuoles. Which are carrying food in the form of granules, and they are also known to be non-living substances. And organelles like nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, they all are membrane bound within the cell membrane. Now we will start with nucleus. So what we can see here, that this is the nucleus, and nucleus is having this outer covering is nuclear membrane. It is nuclear membrane, and these nuclear membrane are having pores which are known as nuclear pore. And this thread-like structure which we can see is known as chromatin. And again, we have fluid material inside the nucleus, and that fluid material inside nucleus is known as nucleoplasm. And together, nucleoplasm and cytoplasm are known as protoplasm. Now this chromatin, now other structure which we can see here, this is known as nucleolus. And within nucleolus, the ribosomal RNA is synthesized. Now chromatin is very important because chromatin, which is a thread-like structure, are having DNA segments. And these DNA segments are having genes on them which are responsible for character inheritance. Now this nucleus undergoes division, and nucleus division is known as karyokinesis, and there are two forms of divisions in nucleus which are known as equational division or mitosis, and other type of division is known as reduction division, which is also known as meiosis. And what mitosis and meiosis do? In mitosis case, the growth and repair type of mechanisms takes place for the cells, like growth, the cells responsible for the growth, like by proliferation of cells. And repair means that if any cell got injured, are replaced by new cells. These all mechanisms are taking place by the mitosis process. And for reductional division or meiosis, the gamete cells are formed. Now next comes is the endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulums are very next structure to the nucleus, and they are in two forms. They are in either smooth or in ribosome attached form, and ribosome attached form is known as rough endoplasmic reticulum, and this is known as smooth endoplasmic reticulum. So again, RER is the site for protein synthesis. Now in nucleus, one more point I would like to add here, which is about centrosomes. So centrosomes are basically helping in the formation of spindle fiber at the time of division of cell, or when the karyokinesis and cytokinesis are taking place. Next structure is of Golgi apparatus, and what Golgi apparatus do? They basically form vesicles, and they are mainly responsible for the secretion of hormones and enzymes, and they are also helping in glycosylation. That means the carbohydrates attaching with the protein is all taking place by Golgi apparatus. And one more important role of Golgi apparatus is that they help in synthesizing lysosomes. So now next we will see about lysosomes. We had seen that lysosomes are synthesized by Golgi apparatus, and lysosomes are mainly having hydrolytic enzymes, and these hydrolytic enzymes are mainly acidic in nature, having pH 4.5 to 5. Now what is the role of lysosomes? So basically it is important for phagocytosis. What basically they do, they digest their own food during starvation, and that's why they are also known as suicide bag. And hydrolytic enzymes like nucleases, proteases, that are denaturing. Next is the ribosomes. So ribosomes are 70S. 70S, they are mainly present in bacteria. And 80S, S is basically the Seidelberg unit, and 80S is for both animals and plants. So what they are basically doing, they are helping in protein synthesis from RNA, and this process is also known as translation. Now next important organelle is mitochondria, which is again a membrane bound organelle. And what we can see here, this mitochondria are having their own DNA, which is in a circular form, and they are having their own ribosomes. So ribosomes are present in nucleolus, mitochondria, in cytoplasm, and on endoplasmic reticulum. So this is very important information for ribosomes, that where they all are present. So in cytoplasm mainly they are in free form. In endoplasmic reticulum they are attached on the surface, and that's why we are calling them rough endoplasmic reticulum. They are present in nucleolus. So in nucleolus they are present in form of rRNA, which is ribosomal rRNA. So nucleolus is again a protein synthesis site, and in mitochondria as well. Now in case of mitochondria, the ribosomes which are present are 70S, and within the cristae, that is the inner folding of mitochondria, the matrix is present, and that matrix is known as mitochondrial matrix. And these mitochondria are mainly responsible for cellular respiration, like we had seen for Krebs cycle in both plants and animals. And they are also having stored ATP, which is known as energy currency. They are known as energy currency. One more organelle is present, that is known as peroxisome. And their role is to, the enzymes present in these peroxisome are catalase, that are helping in oxidation. So this is all from animal cell. Now we will see plant cell. We are at our last part, that is plant cell. And in plant cell, we will see some of the differences from animal cell. Like we can see that in plant cell, they have a cell wall. And these cell walls are mainly made of cellulose. cellulose are the major component for cell wall formation. And plasmodesmata are mainly the junctions that are formed between two cells. So these cell walls basically provide the shape and rigidity to the cells, and they are completely free from permeability. That means the substances that will come, that will enter from this plasmodesmata junction, will directly pass from the free walls without any selective permeability. Now when it will move to the cell membrane, then there the permeability will be occurring. Otherwise, from cell wall there will be no permeability. Now after cell wall, we will see the organelles that are present in plant cells, like mitochondria, as we had seen in animal cells, Golgi. So Golgi apparatus here, or the Golgi bodies of plant cells, are known as dictyosomes. And here we can see the endoplasmic reticulum with ribosomes and without ribosomes, and nucleus and nucleolus are also present here. And what we can see that here the vacuole size are very large, and within vacuoles the cell sap are present. In case of animal cells, the vacuole cells are very small and they are very less present, but in plant cells they are majorly found. And next, what we can see here, that the chloroplast. Now chloroplast again having a ribosome that is of 70S, and we had also seen 70S ribosomes are present in mitochondria of animal cells. Now what we can see here, that we can see that these structure, which is known as granum, and what basically these structures are having, they are filled with chlorophyll in them. The chlorophyll pigments are filled within them, and the line which is shown that are connecting them is known as lamella. Now here we will see that different plastids of plant cells, and they are chloroplast, which is having chlorophyll pigments and carotenoid pigments that are mainly playing role for the photosynthesis. Next we can see here that the chromoplast, they mainly provide colors to the petals and to the fruits, and the pigments mainly are xanthophylls and carotene. And the third one is leucoplast. So basically in leucoplast there is no pigment, they are completely colorless, the starch is present in them, and the food store, and they are mainly known as food storage site. And one of the example is amyloplast, which is present in potato, which stores starch. That's why we had seen in potato that it is completely colorless. So this is all from this part. In my next video, I will discuss about that, how every activity of a living organism is an outcome of cellular activity. And with the last part, I will end up this chapter. So if you have any doubt, any query, write it in the comment section. You can also message me on my Instagram. Link is in the description box. Thank you for watching.